With any luck, school children all over the country will take up the challenge and organise sponsored jump-offs, which for some reason is what they're calling skipping events. This morning's youngest volunteers have all been victims of heart disease who've recently taken to the rope and who were so keen it seemed a shame to stop them for a chat.
What's the easy bit? What's the hardest thing about the skipping lark?
She's trying to get in time for jumping over. Could you get a lot of exercise out of it?
Certainly do. Very hard work. Elliot, what's the hardest thing about skipping? Try not to fall over. So, Elliot. We give up.
And that's the problem. Youngsters have given up. Recent surveys show that up to 80% of school children get precious little exercise. Skipping's almost died out in most playgrounds, but not at Gospel Oak Primary, where it's become something of a craze. It helps youngsters play together as well as being good exercise, and that's what today's campaign's all about.
Interestingly, in Australia and in America and in New Zealand, it's become extremely fashionable, almost a craze. And in Japan, it's very, very popular, so we think it should become popular again in Britain.
To help that happen, the newly formed Jump Rope Display Team will tour the country, showing off the more intricate steps you can work up with a bit of practice. But even they'd be hard put to beat the world champion. Albert Rainier can make the rope travel at 200 miles an hour, and he's 64.